Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial. Today I'm going to dive into the fascinating world of mitochondria. I will be showcasing how to do image analysis using ImageJ, which is a very powerful open source image processing program designed for scientific multidimensional images. I will be exploring how to analyze various aspects of 3D mitochondrial images and to obtain information such as distribution of mitochondria, their proximity to each other, and much more. These analyses help me to understand a wealth of information and allow me to characterize behavior and characteristics of mitochondria in 3D space. So without further ado, let's get started. I've opened my ImageJ, and I'm going to navigate over to the folder where I have my images saved. I'm going to randomly pick one to kind of demo this out for all of you. So what I've done here is I've cropped my cells to make my analysis semi-single cell based. And as I'm panning up and down, you can see the shapes of mitochondria, and they look pretty close to being round. But because this is a 3D stack, Z stack, we ought to be able to analyze this in 3D before making a conclusion about the exact nature of the mitochondria shape. So let's go ahead and open up the Mitochondria Analyzer, and it is a plugin for ImageJ. I will put the link to the GitHub page for this plugin, and you guys will be able to download it from there. The instructions are there. There's a user manual, very nice user manual. I highly recommend that you read it. But in this tutorial, I'm just going to go through the steps that I utilize myself to be able to analyze the Z stacks of mitochondria that are shown here. So to begin my analysis, I convert all of my images to 8-bit, and then I set the scale. And this is where you tell ImageJ how many pixels are within a micron. And to be able to use the Mitochondria Analyzer, you have to set the scale to microns. You have to specify this micron for Mitochondria Analyzer to be able to function. So again, 8-bit conversion, and then set the scale to microns. Next, let's threshold the image, and I don't need these. Let me change this to 1.2, 1.1, and this to 3. Okay, that should do it, so click OK. And one nice thing I like about this is that it allows you to kind of visually check how good your threshold is. And then that next one is the thresholded image binary. Let's view this in 3D to get an understanding of what it looks like in 3D space. So here you can see the three-dimensional thresholded shapes of the mitochondrial intensities. So now let's talk about what you can actually do with this ROI data that you have. So one of the questions that you can ask with this sort of a setup is, what is the relationship between the mitochondria themselves and their distances? So let me take, for example, mitochondria number one and number 6 here, and take a distance measurement between those two. And with the click of a button, you can get the distances between different objects. So for example, object number 1 and 6 are approximately like 4.011 microns apart, border to border. So the border of object 1 is 4.011 microns away from object 6. Right, so you can get a wealth of information from all of this data. And then if you're feeling lucky and you want to look at larger files, you can select all and just sort out your data. And here you have, you know, individual mitochondria and their relationship to all the other mitochondria in your file. All right, so I hope this is making a lot of sense. So these are the, you can understand proximity of mitochondria to each other and to other objects in space. For example, you can very easily, you know, threshold your nuclei with a nuclear stain and understand the center to border relationship between all of these mitochondria. So for example, if a treatment makes your mitochondria move further away from your nucleus, you can pick up on that, right? So you can take an image before and an image after your treatment so that you can see how your mitochondria are shifting temporally and spatially. And you can very easily do that type of a thing with this type of an analysis. Now here's another way that you can analyze your mitochondria, and that is through the 3D analysis option on the mitochondria analyzer itself. Now, I personally, I like to pick per cell and per mitochondria way to perform the analysis, and this way I can save both CSV files that are generated, and it just saves me an extra few seconds. So here you can see there are two files that get generated. On the right is the per cell normalized counts and volume, and on the left are each individual mitochondria's data set. And then you can take this and do further analysis, break this down, look at different sizes of mitochondria that are present within your experimental groups or whatever conditions you're working with. So this is built into Mitochondria Analyzer. And when you go and set up your Mitochondria Analyzer, it will ask you to download all the dependencies, and then all that information is in the user manual. Another useful way to analyze your mitochondria thresholds is to do it through the 3D manager. So if you take your objects that are identified by threshold and pull them into 3D manager, select all, and you can press this measure 3D button. So here's another useful result that you can obtain for the mitochondria that you have. So here you, on the top, you can see the X and Y coordinates are listed. There are other useful things that are listed here. For example, the ratio of a mitochondria volume to a rectangular bounding box, and that can become very useful in certain instances. There are other things like sphericity, the centroids for the mitochondria. So if you need to do any kind of calculation that is perimeter driven for the mitochondria, you can utilize this data. Now this is very similar to the data output that's given by the Mitochondria Analyzer, but this one just gives you a little bit extra mathematical information with all the ratios that it calculates for you. The ratio, for example, of a mitochondria volume to an elliptical shape, for example, right? So that can help you understand, is my mitochondria more round, more close to a circle, or is the shape more close to an elliptical shape? So all of this information is available to you, and you can utilize this very quickly and easily through ImageJ's built-in functions. And in my next video, I will go ahead and show you guys how to use a Jupyter script to take all of this data and and to utilize it in another fashion to do some k-mean clustering, so you can get some understanding of where your mitochondria data falls within relationship to the mean clusters that can be generated from your data set. So if you're interested in learning how to do that, please stay tuned for my next video.